President Muhammadu Buhari has signed into law the Appropriation Bill of 2023, totaling 21.8 trillion naira. President Buhari signed the bill at the council chambers of the State House in Abuja. Given details of the bill, the president pledged that adequate provisions have been made in the budget for the successful conduct of the forthcoming general elections and the transition program. He also directed the Minister of Finance, Budget and National Planning to engage with the legislature to revisit some of the changes made to the executive budget proposal. Our correspondent Simiso Ladigun tells us more in this next report.
After rectifying problems that emanated from the executive in the process of preparing the 2023 Appropriation Bill, President Muhammadu Buhari has signed the 21.8 trillion naira budget into law to usher in the new year. Speaking at the signing of the eighth and final annual budget of his administration, the president said the aggregate expenditures is an increase of 1.32 trillion naira over the initial executive proposal for a total expenditure of 20.51 trillion naira. The president said that the 2023 budget was developed to promote fiscal sustainability, macroeconomic stability, and ensure smooth transition to the incoming administration.
We have examined the changes made by the National Assembly to the 2023 executive budget proposal. The amended fiscal framework for 2023, as approved by the National Assembly, shows additional revenues of 765.79 billion naira and an unfunded deficit of 553.46 billion naira.
President Buhari said his decision to sign the 2023 Appropriation Bill into law, as passed by the National Assembly, was to enable its implementation commence without delay, considering the imminent transition process to another democratically elected government. He added that his administration would speed up critical infrastructure projects nationwide as it raced towards the finish line on May 29 this year.
The Ministry of Finance, Budget and National Planning will work towards early release of the 2023 capital votes to enable ministries, departments and agencies to commence the implementation of their capital projects early in support of our efforts to deliver key projects and public services, as well as improve the living conditions of our people.
While commending the National Assembly on the successful signing of the budget, the President of the Senate, Ahmed Lawan, and Speaker of the House of Representatives, Femi Gbajabiamila, said the major reason for passing the budget at record time is to ensure the implementation of projects.
I think the National Assembly has done very well in meeting its constitutional mandate and giving the country all arms of government to be on board to give a true working document for the country. The executive did everything they could, and we have even a wider view, a bird's eye view of what's going on in all the agencies, and we have also complemented what the executive has done.
Nigeria faces challenges of revenue, and this is going to be our focus. This is going to be what the National Assembly, both chambers, will ensure that we get revenues, we find more sources, better sources, stabilize the sources, and of course look into some of the legislations and some of the waivers and concessions granted to see whether or not they deserve to continue to be implemented in the way and manner they were approved.
President Buhari also signed into law the 2022 Supplementary Appropriation Act, which, according to him, would enable the administration to respond to the havoc caused by the recent nationwide floods in the infrastructure and agriculture sectors. Simisola Adigun, TV 360, Abuja.